Laboratory measurement of bilirubin. Do you know how bilirubin is measured in the blood? In part 2 of our Chalk Talk series on bilirubin, we'll delve into its measurement in the lab. First, let's look at the types of bilirubin in the blood. There are two types: conjugated bilirubin, which is water-soluble and present in plasma, and unconjugated bilirubin, which is water-insoluble and binds nonspecifically to albumin. For practical reasons, only conjugated bilirubin and total bilirubin are measured in the lab. The two forms of bilirubin in the blood are measured using a dye. The dye reacts with the bilirubin, forming a red compound, which is measured photometrically. Based on this value, bilirubin levels can be calculated. In the first measurement, the dye is added directly to the serum sample and reacts mainly with conjugated bilirubin. Because conjugated bilirubin reacts directly with the reagent, it's also termed direct bilirubin. In contrast, unconjugated bilirubin reacts slowly and is barely detectable. In a second measurement step, alcohol is added to the serum sample. Alcohol accelerates the reaction between unconjugated bilirubin and the dye. One of the mechanisms proposed to describe this effect is the dissociation of bilirubin from albumin. However, the chemical basis of this effect is unclear, but appears to be due to rearrangement within the bilirubin molecule. The addition of the dye to the serum sample results in a reaction between the dye and both unconjugated and conjugated bilirubin. In this step, total bilirubin is measured. Subsequently, the concentration of unconjugated bilirubin is calculated. Conjugated bilirubin is subtracted from total bilirubin, which gives unconjugated bilirubin. Because of this indirect measurement, unconjugated bilirubin is also termed indirect bilirubin. In the clinical setting, the term direct bilirubin is used for conjugated bilirubin and indirect bilirubin for unconjugated bilirubin. Unconjugated bilirubin accounts for approximately 80% of bilirubin present in the blood of healthy individuals. Now let's move on to disorders associated with bilirubin metabolism. These can have different clinical presentations. The patient's stool and urine color are important aspects of their medical history. Stool discoloration occurs in biliary tract disorders because bilirubin is unable to reach the colon. Dark urine is a feature of elevated conjugated bilirubin levels in the blood, which can indicate a hepatic or biliary tract disorder. Clinical findings include jaundice, which is first noted as a yellow discoloration of the eyes, followed by the skin and mucous membranes. The urine dipstick test is used to determine the presence of bilirubinuria and/or urobilinogenuria. Total and direct bilirubin can be measured in serum. Here, it's interesting to note how high bilirubin levels are and how unconjugated and conjugated bilirubin relate to one another. Would you like to test your knowledge with questions related to our two episodes on bilirubin? Just click on the link.